The name of the book is Conversations with Maniratnam. It is, as the book's name suggests, a series of conversations with the director, and it was a set of conversations recorded over several months, and the book is divided into a number of chapters, and each chapter talks about a single film. So over a period of time, we captured different facets of filmmaking and the things that went into the movie, and we went about trying to deconstruct the different films and see what was in them and things like that. Yeah, I'm a film critic. I've been writing about cinema for 10 years, one of the reasons I chose to write about Maniratnam is because Penguin, my publisher, was trying to get me to write a book for a long time. And this was a subject that interested both of us. And I think what really interested me was, I'm very familiar with his work, both in Tamil and in Hindi. And I think that he is one of the most important filmmakers we have, simply because we don't have that many filmmakers straddling the mainstream genre anymore, who try to infuse a level of artistry into mainstream cinema. And that was there a lot more in earlier eras with people like Raj Kapoor and Guru Dutt and all that. But after some time, you know, cinema split into two. And the people who really wanted to say things, who really had ideas, they went into the arty kind of mold, or what we try to call parallel cinema. And the others who worked within the mainstream were content doing, I'm not saying they did bad films, but they limited themselves to certain things. And Maniratnam is one of the last of those filmmakers from that era who still tries to do very different kind of mainstream films, and that's very interesting for me. So that was one of the main reasons I did the book. It was originally supposed to be a book of essays. Because he's in Chennai and I'm in Chennai, I went to tell him that such a book has been commissioned and I'm writing a book. And then he didn't seem very thrilled about it. And then he said, well, you like cinema and I like cinema, let's just talk and see what happens. So I thought, yes, I mean, this was interesting, because that book of essays I could write any time, but here he himself was saying that he'd like to talk about his films. So even so, the first couple of times I thought, after our sessions, I tried to write it in an essayistic kind of format. But then I found that his voice wasn't coming through as clearly as I wanted. And this was, after all, a book between two people. It has both my voice in it and his voice in it. And I thought that the conversational format was the best way to keep our voice. And we took a lot of trouble, or at least I took a lot of trouble, to make sure that people understood that this was a conversational book and not just a Q&A. And that this was, you know, as much about my questions as about his answers. And it was rather a back and forth kind of thing. And I thought that this conversational format kept it best way. And we have had sterling books like that. We've had the Truffaut Hitchcock book. We've had the Walter Murch, Michael Ondaatje book. We've had the Billy Wilder, Cameron Crowe book. So these are, I mean, it's an established format when two people very serious about the medium have this conversation. So I thought that was a good way to go. Yeah, I have spoken a lot as well. In fact, one of the criticisms of the book from certain quarters was that, you know, I keep yapping too much and don't let the director talk enough. But that was intentional, because, you know, it's still he's being asked. But one thing that you have to understand is that unless your question is really specific, you're not going to get a very specific answer from anybody, any creator. You know, if you just ask him, what was it like to work on this movie, you're not going to get anything worth it. You have to go very, very deep into what exactly you want and try to extract that. And only then is he going to give you a specific answer. Because otherwise, you're only dealing with generics. And I wanted this to be a very, like, basically, you know, if you wanted me to be very graphic about it, I wanted to basically take a drill and bore into a skull. That was the intent of the book, and that you can do only if you're very specific about the kind of questions you ask. So that's what one of the things. The book is divided into chapters based on each film. So yes, we did start talking about the first film and end with the last film. So that was a sequential progress that went. So I did have a rough outline of questions in mind. But that's just the starting point, because you never know where it's going to take you. You know, when you have an interview, it's never good to be too rigid in these kind of things. So yeah, I would do it. But then if he was offering something and taking off on something, then I'd be a fool not to follow that line of inquiry. So yeah, it was a bit of both. It is, no, we kept, there are no other art forms. We talked only about cinema. And if we did talk about other art forms, it was in terms of how it applied to cinema. For instance, I asked him if he used the way, you know, how cinematographers in Hollywood and European cinema, they often use paintings by the Renaissance painters and other such things as reference points for their lighting. They'll often go to Caravaggio or something and say, okay, you know what, the light in this is like this and things like that. So I asked him, you know, if he ever used reference points like that. So yeah, in those kinds of ways, but it was only about cinema. We didn't really go away from cinema because that was pretty much what we had to cover. And if while talking about, let's say, film 2, he suddenly remembered something about film 8. And, you know, we talk about that for a while. And then, so as much as, see, the objective is we try to keep the book as sequential as possible. But then this would go into chapter 8 when that editing happened. Yeah. It was necessary to edit because as much as possible, I didn't change his voice or my voice. But sometimes when talking, you cannot have a book where it is precisely what was recorded because it's going to become very, you know, questions have to be of a certain length and answers have to be of a certain length. You cannot, because you're collating those answers into one coherent answer and you cannot have things that go all over the place. So there is a certain amount of editing done needs to be done. Otherwise, you know, you're going to get a very haphazard kind of thing. So yeah, that amount of editing is there. But I tried my best not to deviate from, because one of the other things about this book is that it is as much about the two people talking about cinema as much as it is about the growing relationship between a filmmaker and a critic, because we didn't know each other, we hadn't talked much to each other before. So the first, if you look at the first chapter, my questions are direct and to the point, and I'm also a little intimidated by him, but as we start talking and as we start talking, I kind of assume a role where I'm more comfortable with him. I'm not afraid to ask him certain questions that could be seen as uncomplimentary and things like that. So that was another, that's another part of the book, the arc of this relationship between two people who often are not always on the same side while film is being discussed. We pretty much went into, like there was one chapter where we talked about editing, one chapter where we talked about cinematography, we talked a lot about the acting, about what he does, about the writing, and about his song picturization especially, because I think one of the things we don't talk enough about our films, and especially now when songs have become relegated to just things that provide a momentary high in the screenplay. It's not, you know, it's very necessary to recognize the fact that the songs take off at a particular point and they land at a particular point in the narrative, and they're very much a continuous part of what is being told. So how he does that, how he struggles with it, actually, that if you read this book, one of the things you get about is how difficult it is to take an element like a song, which is so extraneous. I mean, it's a foreign element that is incorporated into the film. To take that kind of song and make it feel organic to the narrative, it's one of the most difficult things. And, you know, you can see how much he struggles with it. So we talked about that a lot. And we talked about the other things as well, art direction, set decoration, things like that. Not at all. He's one of the most flexible person. He is not afraid to take ideas from anybody as long as it works for the film. So it's, he's not, you know, very rigid at all. And even while doing the book, he completely, you know, he did not dictate any particular thing that he wanted it to be this way or that way. He pretty much left himself in my hands. Of course, after seeing some of the transcripts, he would kind of say, you know, let's do this again. Let's do a retake, if you will. You know, let's kind of, this is not sounding very good. Let's just go over it again. So those we'd kind of, you know, go over again. But yeah, otherwise he's not flexible. He wants the product to be good. And he wanted this book, the kind of attention that he gave to this book, even though it's technically my book, was simply amazing because, you know, he just like gave up so much of his time for this book. No. The thing is, again, like that's what I was saying. So he has a certain idea in mind, and if a cinematographer comes to him and says, I think we better use it this way because of things. See, you cannot be like that on a set anyway, because if you go to in the middle of a jungle to shoot and it's raining, you're that's, you have to deal with it because you have the dates of the actors in a particular way. Because unless you're doing a very minimalistic kind of film with actors who are pretty much given themselves up to you, you cannot do that because this actor has to be back at some other set at the particular date. So you need to get that. So you have to be flexible. One of the things about the book that does come out is how things change. And he's very responsive to suggestions by other people. That's what I was trying to say. It wasn't actually, but one of the things that the feedback that we got from a lot of people is there was a lot of gratitude from aspiring filmmakers and also people who've made films about how useful this book has been in planning and executing certain things and what to think about. Because first of all, they were amazed that someone could think so much while making a movie, where pretty much they were amazed by the fact that so much thought goes into a movie about even the smaller things. There were things like he talked about building a set at a certain height so that at this particular time the sunlight could come through and things like that. And those things were always, they amazed people, because to kind of have that kind of vision, first of all, and then to execute it that particular way and things like that. So it has come out somewhat inadvertently as, I wouldn't say it's a tutorial, because it's not a step-by-step kind of conversation. But yes, it has come out as a kind of a how-to book on certain things, yeah. Like I said, one of the things is that we live in an age where there's a lot of fragmentation in anything that we do. There are different audiences for different things. And, there are people doing exclusively niche multiplex movies, and a movie that comes out, he's one of the last filmmakers who wants to capture everyone from age 6 to 60 and give them a cinematic experience that's full of song and dance and melodrama and also something with a bit of integrity, with a lot of integrity. His, like I said in the book, in the introduction, his films may work or they may not work for you, but one thing that no one can deny is the kind of work that's gone into his films and the kind of integrity with which it's been done. Because, that there is only so much you have control over what the end product is, but he makes sure that it's 200% that he and his team gives to the film, well, across all aspects of the film, and that's something that really impresses you.